For some people, Hinduism is like they want a very monolithic structure of Hinduism, like Islam and Christianity. They despise Islam and Christianity, but on the other hand, they get inspired from them so much. They want a monolithic structure for Islam, I mean Hinduism, like okay, Hinduism is only what is given in the Bhagavad Gita or in one text, in Sanskrit text. But I think Hinduism is not like that. All the traditions, I mean, when I said about animal sacrifices, they are like, oh, these are tribal traditions, this is not Hinduism. Tribal tradition is also Hinduism because tribes are within India. Anything that happens within India is Hinduism. Like, that is my definition. I mean, this is the academic definition of Hinduism, that it is an umbrella term for all the traditions existing within Hinduism. It is not necessary that it is there in some Sanskrit text written thousands of years ago, and then only it is Hinduism. It's not like that. It can be a very recent thing, but if it is in the culture, then it is Hinduism. It's a part of Hinduism.
It's very interesting because the people who want to defend Hinduism, first, they say Hinduism is many things. It's not just one, like, it's not one thing,
yeah,
like
Christianity. Yeah, yeah.
And then when you say, like, okay, this is, I have a problem with this in Hinduism, and they say, oh, this is not Hinduism. And I'm like, wait a minute.
You said,
like, you cannot say this is not Hinduism, and Hinduism is so many different things at the same time. If this is not Hinduism, then there's a core thing that is Hinduism. And if it's a core thing that is Hinduism, then what are the fundamental things that makes something Hinduism? And if there is no fundamental thing and it's like fluid, then what I'm criticizing as part of Hinduism, then it's part of Hinduism, because you just told me that many things could be part of Hinduism. So like they want to have their cake and eat it too. Like it's weird. Yeah.
And another thing is that, like, suppose in the earlier video I talked about Gita Govinda, a text which is like a 10th or 11th century text, which was written, I mean, it is about Radha and Krishna, the love between them. And I shared some, a bit like erotic verses from that text. And some people are like, oh, don't mislead the people. Gita Govinda is not a scripture for Hindus and all. I'm like, okay. See, in Hinduism, there is no like authentic, I mean, yes, there are authentic scriptures, like, this is like a titular, like we say Vedas are the authentic scriptures. But in reality, this is not the case. How many Hindus know what is there in the Vedas? I think 90% or 99% of the Hindus don't even know what is the content of the Vedas. They don't know. Mm-hmm. For them, like a local bhajan, that is devotional song, which was written maybe 100 years ago, or even a song of the Bollywood, a devotional song from the Bollywood, makes more sense than a song from the Vedas. So, I mean... Mm-hmm. So though titular, like, it is like the Queen of England. So it is like a titular position. Vedas are the authentic scriptures. But in reality, there is no authentic scripture in Hinduism. Everything is authentic. There is no like Sahih, Galat, and all these things are not there.
But even in religions, that there is something called authentic and non-authentic and part canon and non-canon. Yeah. People don't know the Quran or know the Bible. That's very similar. Like, that part is very similar with Christianity and Islam. How many Muslims do you think have read the Quran?
Yeah, many Muslims don't know the Quran, I know. But the point is that still they give a whole lot of importance on the Quran. But many sects of Hinduism don't give importance on the reading. I mean, this is just like nominal. They will say that the Vedas are great, but they don't give an importance on the reading of the Vedas. Like in ritual processes in our homes, the Bhagavad Gita may be studied, or maybe the Devi Mahatmya, that the text we were discussing in the last episode also, that text is, I mean, recited in pujas or worshipings. The Vedas are not recited many of the times. I'm not saying they are not at all recited, but they are not recited always.
Yeah, but even when they're recited, people don't know what they're talking about. Like the Quran, Quran is recited all the time. Do you want to respond to Katie?
He's saying something I disagree with so much with this. I didn't understand. Modern borders of India is younger than the term Hinduism. What does it mean?
I don't know. I just said, you know.
Modern borders of India is younger than the term. Okay, I mean, I'm saying like any traditions within India. Okay. So, I mean, he's saying that the modern borders of India. So, anything that exists within the Indian subcontinent. Okay, so it may also be like South Asia also. Like it may be in the South Asia, Thailand, Sri Lanka, anything that is also a part of Hinduism.
You're saying any ideology. Yeah. I don't know if I like your idea, your definition, because let me challenge it, okay? You're saying that anything... Okay, I'm hearing so much echo. Is there any way you could reduce my volume? No?
I can't reduce your volume, by the way.
My volume, not your volume. Reduce my volume.
Yeah, okay?
So you're saying... I've actually heard this definition before. You're saying any ideas that come out of India's subcontinent, that's technically Hinduism? Any?
Yeah, but I mean, see, these terms are not defined. I mean, first of all, for the Hinduism term was coined by Raja Ram Mohan Roy for the first time. And he defined it that way. Like, it was the original definition. Okay, whatever Indian traditions are there, except Buddhism, Jainism, and Sikhism, because these are like organized religions, I mean, in some sense. So apart from that, whatever exists, that is Hinduism.
So the atheist, anti-religious, and materialist philosophers of India, who hated...
Yeah, many people consider them part of Hinduism, but
you can't steal it. Those are our people. You can't take them.
Yeah, but many people consider them, like, there are many naturalistic philosophies growing out of India. They consider it part of Hinduism, definitely. Like, there is a Charvak philosophy, Ajivika philosophy, Buddhist and Jain philosophy also. I consider them part of Hinduism in some sense because they are like Indian traditions. I call it Indianism more like, I don't know how to define that.
Katie is saying I would call that
cultural appropriation.
Oh my God. Yes, you're culturally appropriating atheism.
No, it is not. I mean, actually, yeah.